Tracy Bruner served as the 2016 president of the National Cattlemen's Beef Association. Before Tracy began his term as NCBA president, the Cattlemen to Cattlemen group took a trip to Kansas to learn what his operation is like and what issues were top of mind for him at that time.
Make a trip through the Flint Hills of eastern Kansas, and you just might find Tracy Bruner doing what he loves to do, saddling his horse, riding out to check cattle, and tending to the business of his family's enterprise, the Cow Camp Ranch.
Well, actually, we're the third and fourth and now fifth generations of Bruners farming, ranching, raising cattle here in this part of Kansas. Our operation has evolved into a fairly diversified portion of the beef industry. We have everything from conception to consumption represented in our family entities.
On a daily basis, Tracy leads the feedlot and livestock marketing side of the business, but the Bruner family works together with Tracy and his two brothers, as well as their wives and children, dividing responsibilities in a diverse farming and cattle operation.
Over time, we have become involved in genetics and seed stock production, where we raise bulls and females that go throughout the United States. We also have a farming and feeding enterprise that feeds and finishes cattle right here in our feed yard, which works very well with our grazing operation, our ranching enterprise, if you will, that grazes cattle on the native grasses of the Flint Hills. Additionally, we market those cattle through a value-based marketing system that lets us focus on quality, and not only quality of the cattle that we're raising, but the quality of beef that those cattle produce. This helps us to stay focused on the end product and realize efficiencies all through the beef animals production.
Watch Tracy on horseback or working his way through the feedlot, and you can see this is what he's spent his whole life doing, caring for cattle and working to find ways to continue raising the bar and producing the highest quality beef possible.
I was very fortunate throughout my younger years to be blessed with both family and teachers, pastors, even a county extension agent that were very supportive and very encouraging and expected success. Through the years, the livestock associations, both at the local level as well at the state level, have played a strong role in the continuing education that's very vital for me to stay in touch with not only other producers and other ideas, but new technologies and emerging ways to do things better in a more efficient manner. And so that continuing education and that networking with other producers has always been very important to us.
Always eager to learn more and give back to the industry he loves, Tracy has tackled a variety of volunteer positions in the beef industry on both the state and national level. Most recently, he served as an officer of the National Cattlemen's Beef Association.
I am very much looking forward to being president of NCBA in 2016. I'm looking forward to attending as many state meetings and local events as possible, and seeing as many NCBA members at our national meetings. The real strength of NCBA is through its affiliates. We have over 30,000 direct members, but we also represent 250,000 cattlemen throughout the United States through our affiliates. The state organizations, the state beef councils, the breed affiliates, all are cattlemen that are part of NCBA. We truly represent cattlemen and the cattle industry in our country.
In the year he'll serve as NCBA president, Tracy sees clear priorities that can help grow the American beef cattle business.
Trade is a big one. The Trans-Pacific Partnership that has just been negotiated and signed but still needs to be ratified will be a great thing for our industry. Very important for the next generation of cattlemen in this country. It's a good agreement. It will lower our trade tariffs into our best customer, Japan, from 38% down to 9% over 16 years of the agreement.
Beyond the opportunity to grow U.S. beef exports to Japan and other Pacific Rim markets, Tracy says there are plenty of policy challenges ahead as NCBA works to protect cattle producers and their freedom to operate.
We've been pushing back on the waters of the U.S. rule ever since it was first announced several years ago. It's a classic example of government overreach into areas that just don't need to be under federal control. You know, in the second term of this administration, we've already seen an escalation of the initiatives and the use of the executive order to further the agenda of the administration. We're going to continue to need to be vigilant, to push back in places where things like additional monument designations are used, listing of endangered species are brought forward that will encroach on private property rights and the use of public lands that are so very vital to our cattle industry and our beef production systems throughout the country.
As always, there's no shortage of challenges to face, and in 2016, it's likely that Tracy Bruner will spend more than 200 days away from his home ranch, serving as president of the National Cattlemen's Beef Association and speaking out on behalf of the industry he loves. He'll do so to help ensure a future for family members growing up on his own ranch and for all those who hope to have a future in America's beef industry.
My hope and prayer would be that as many as possible could enjoy the independent lifestyle, the opportunity to run their own business, to work the land, raising animals, and maybe working with their family, providing the high quality food, the highest quality protein that the world knows. I've never been more optimistic about the potential for our industry. With the globalization of economies and new technologies that continue to bring us closer and closer together, all the consumers of the world want to eat better, and that includes our high-quality beef, the premium protein.
On the Cow Camp Ranch in Kansas, I'm Brian Baxter reporting for NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman.